This is my dad. This is my mom. And this is me. But why is it that I'm dark? Why don't I have blue eyes? Or freckles? In 1866, Gregor Mendel, an Australian monk known as the father of modern genetics, through his work on pea plants, discovered the fundamental laws of inheritance. He deduced that genes come in pairs and are inherited as distinct units, one from each parent. Mendel tracked the segregation of parental genes and the appearance of the offsprings as dominant or recessive traits. Which means that some genes we inherit from our parents are dominant, and some don't appear at us at all, but can still appear in later generations. Now, think of DNA as the instructional manual of every living thing. We detect certain characteristics, like the color of your hair and how you walk. But sometimes, during the process of transferring genes from our parents to us, errors occur which create problems in our instructional manual. Faulty genes can cause major health problems like cystic fibrosis, sickle cell anemia, colorblindness, diabetes, autism, and more. Which brings us to the topic for today, genetic editing. So what in the world is gene editing? Genetic editing is the process of altering the genetic code of one or more organisms to produce desired traits. For example, in 2015, doctors used genetic editing techniques to cure baby girls' leukemia. There are many other fields where genetic editing is used today, like in food, research, and medicine.
Now, how exactly does genetic editing work?
Well, it's quite simple, and you don't have to be a biologist to understand it.
Whoa!
It simply works using a method known as CRISPR. Think of CRISPR as a molecular pair of sharpshooting scissors assassin. It's a piece of RNA, ribonucleic acid, that acts as a guidance system and an enzyme in a cell's nucleus. CRISPR's guidance system hunts for a specific DNA sequence like a problematic gene. When CRISPR finds its target, it clamps onto that DNA and slices it. When the cell tries to repair the damage, it uses an engineered, healthy part of the gene to fix it.
Wait, since we could alter genes to cure diseases, we could alter genes to get my dream child. We're too bad, it's just futuristic. Wait, what if it's not? In the year 2000, Adam Nash became the first genetically engineered baby.
There are three methods by which it's done: pre-implantation genetic diagnosis, TALENs, and CRISPR.
X can be screened for gender, appearance, intelligence, diseases, and personality, hence the almighty designer baby, with its younger cousin, the three-person baby. This is a procedure by which a baby has three genetic parents, with the third person providing the healthy mitochondrial DNA.
As scientists begin to perfect these genetic editing techniques, the possibilities are endless. We could increase brain function, muscle mass, or eyesight, lifespans could be lengthened, and new human abilities could be developed. Never say never. With genetic editing, the possibilities are endless. What wouldn't you give for a flawless life? I say this breakthrough starts now.